हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम डॉक्टर चंद्रकांत टीमोरे। आई हार्टली वेलकम टू ऑल ऑफ यू इन माय यूट्यूब चैनल। इन दिस वीडियो आई विल बी टॉकिंग ऑन साइक्लोट्रॉन एज पार्टिकल एक्सेलरेटर। आफ्टर केयरफुल व्यू ऑफ दिस वीडियो यू विल बी अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट आर द पार्टिकल एक्सेलरेटर्स, व्हाई पार्टिकल एक्सेलरेटर्स आर वाइडली यूज्ड इन न्यूक्लियर एंड पार्टिकल फिजिक्स, एंड प्रिंसिपल कंस्ट्रक्शन वर्किंग थ्योरी एंड लिमिटेशंस ऑफ साइक्लोट्रॉन्स। ओके, माय फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज व्हाट आर द पार्टिकल एक्सेलरेटर्स। पार्टिकल एक्सेलरेटर्स आर द एपरेटस और डिवाइसेस और मशीन्स दैट आर यूज्ड फॉर इंक्रीजिंग द काइनेटिक एनर्जी ऑफ द चार्ज पार्टिकल for research in nuclear and particle physics. Okay. My second question is, why the particle accelerators are widely used in nuclear and particle physics? Friends, we know that matter is one of the most important fundamental building block of the universe. And matter is made up of atoms. In an atom, negatively charged electrons are revolving around the positively charged dense central region which is called as nucleus. So the study of nucleus is very important because it leads to the applications such as nuclear power, industrial and agricultural isotopes, nuclear medicine, nuclear weapons and radiocarbon dating. But how to study the nucleus? To study nucleus, it is very essential to send external charge particle inside the nucleus. Let me draw the diagram of the nucleus and whole atom. Suppose this is a nucleus and this is the orbit of the electron. The electron is revolving in an orbit having negative charge and the nucleus having positive charge. Inside the nucleus, there are protons and neutrons. So to study the nucleus, it is very essential to send external charge particle. Okay. But potential barrier of the nucleus is very high, of the order of mega electron volt. So the ordinary charge particle cannot cross the potential barrier of the nucleus and cannot enter into the nucleus and cannot retrieve the information of the nucleus. So it is very essential to increase the kinetic energy of this charge particle. This charge particle having more kinetic energy can cross the potential barrier of the nucleus and enter into the nucleus and retrieve the information about the nucleus. Okay. The particle accelerators plays very important role. The particle accelerators are used for increasing the kinetic energy of the charged particle so that the particle can cross the potential barrier of the nucleus and enter into the nucleus. So the particle accelerators are widely used in nuclear and particle physics. Okay. There are types of accelerators such as linear accelerators, static accelerators and circular type of accelerators. I will explain one of the most important circular type accelerator, that is the cyclotron. Now let us move to the invention and principle of the cyclotron. Cyclotron was first built by Ernest Lawrence and Milton Livingston in the year of 1929-31 at the University of California, Berkeley in United States of America. So in 1939, Professor Lawrence was awarded Nobel Prize in Physics for the achievement in the conception and development of the cyclotron. Now, what is the principle on which the cyclotron works? The principle on which the cyclotron works is that when charged particle moves in a path perpendicular to the uniform magnetic field, then magnetic Lorentz force acts on the particle and So the particle moves in a circular path. This is the principle of the cyclotron. Okay. Now let us move to the construction of the cyclotron. In simplest form, cyclotron consists of two flat semicircular metal boxes made up of highly conducting material such as copper. The metal boxes looks like English capital letter D. Let me show the shape of the D. These are the D's. Okay. And the shape of the these boxes looks like English capital letter D. Okay. These two D's are separated by small gap like this. Okay. Let me draw the diagram for the construction of the cyclotron. This is 1D denoted by D1, and this is another D denoted by D2. Okay. These two D's are separated by a small gap. At the central part, iron source is placed, which is denoted by S. The radio frequency oscillator having very high potential of the order of 10 raised to 4 to 10 raised to 5 volts and frequency of the order of 10 raised to 7 hertz is connected in between these two D's like this. Radio frequency oscillator. Now this apparatus is enclosed in a vacuum chamber and the whole apparatus is placed horizontally in between two pole pieces of strong electromagnet. So this is the top view of the cyclotron, top view, and the side view of the cyclotron. Let me draw the diagram. This is the vacuum chamber, and inside this vacuum chamber there are two D's like this, D1 and D2, and iron source is denoted by S, and this vacuum chamber including these D's are placed horizontally in between two pole pieces of strong electromagnet denoted by S and N. Okay. This is the side view. Okay. Okay. This is the construction of the cyclotron. Now, let us move to the working of the cyclotron. The radio frequency oscillator is connected across the two D's, D1 and D2. The radio frequency oscillator makes D1 and D2 alternately positive and negative at the same rate exactly equal to the frequency of the oscillator. Suppose positive ion is emitted from the source exactly at that instant when D1 is positive and D2 is negative, then what will happen? The positive ion will be attracted towards D2 because D2 has negative charge and the ion has positive charge. In the interior of the D2 there is a magnetic field. So magnetic Lorentz force will act on the positive ion, and this positive ion will traverse circular path like this. Okay. Now when this positive ion comes to the edge of D2, and suppose at that time D1 becomes negative and D2 becomes positive, what will happen? The positive ion will be attracted towards the D1, and it will traverse circular path due to the magnetic present in the interior of the D1. But in this case, the positive ion will receive additional acceleration with increasing radius. Now suppose this positive ion comes to the edge of D1, and at that time D1 becomes positive and D2 becomes negative. What will happen? This positive ion again will be attracted into the D2, and it will again traverse circular path. But while crossing this gap, this positive ion will receive additional acceleration with increasing radius. This process continues further, and finally this positive ion will be accelerated, and when this positive ion reaches to the periphery of the disk, then maximum accelerated positive ion will be taken out from circular path to the linear path by using deflector, and this highly accelerated positive ion is allowed to hit the target for further nuclear study. Okay, that was the working of the cyclotron. Okay, now let us move to the theory of the cyclotron, which is very important. In this theory, we will see the expression for frequency of revolution of the positive ion inside the cyclotron, then resonance condition for maximum acceleration, then time required to complete semicircular path, as well as time period of the positive ion inside the cyclotron, and last, the expression for the maximum energy attained by the positive ion inside the cyclotron. Okay, suppose M is mass of the positive ion, Q is charge of the positive ion, and this positive ion is moving in a circular path with velocity V. Then centripetal force is balanced by force due to magnetic field. So I can write mv square upon r, that is centripetal force, and that is balanced by force due to magnetic field, where m is mass, v is velocity of the ion, r is radius of the circular path, b is magnetic field, q is charge of the ion. So from this equation, I can write this v and this v, when v is cancelled, and we can write v upon r is equal to bq upon m. Okay, so this is the equation number 1. But angular velocity denoted by omega is equal to V upon R is equal to BQ upon M. Suppose this is equation number 2. We also know the relationship between omega and linear frequency, given by omega is equal to 2 pi F. Equation number 3. Using equation number 2 and 3, we can write 2 pi f is equal to bq upon m. Therefore, f is equal to bq upon 2 pi m. This is equation number 4. This equation 4 is nothing but expression for the frequency of revolution of the positive ion in the cyclotron. Okay, Now, what will be the resonance condition? When the frequency of revolution of the positive ion is exactly equal to the frequency of the radio frequency oscillator, then maximum acceleration of the positive ion will take place, and that is called as resonance condition. So I can write here the resonance condition, that is frequency of ion is equal to radio frequency oscillator, and that is equal to BQ upon 2 pi m. Suppose this is equation number 5. This equation number 5 is nothing but resonance condition. Okay. Now let us move to the expression for the time taken by the positive ion to complete semicircular path. Okay. This time taken by the semicircular path is given by pi r upon v. Why? What is the reason? Because time is nothing but distance traveled by velocity. To complete one circle, the distance traveled is equal to 2 pi r. But to complete half the circle, that is pi r. That is 2 pi r upon 2, that is equal to pi r. That is pi r is the distance traveled in a semicircular path. So time taken by the positive ion to complete semicircular path is pi r upon v. Okay. We know the value of v by r from equation number 2. V upon r is equal to bq upon m. So we can put the value of v upon r in this equation. So this equation becomes t is equal to pi v upon r is equal to bq upon m, therefore r upon v is equal to m upon bq. So it becomes pi m upon bq. Suppose this is equation number 6. The expression 6 shows the time taken by the positive ion to complete semicircular path. Now what will be the time period, that is time taken by the positive ion to complete one whole cycle or one revolution, that is t is given by 2t. So this time period of the revolution of the positive ion, that is equal to 2 into t, means 2 pi m upon bq. And this is suppose equation number 7. So this is the expression for time period of the revolution of the positive ion inside the cyclotron. Okay. Now the next part of the theory of cyclotron is expression for maximum energy attained by the positive ion in the cyclotron. We know that the expression for energy is given by E is equal to half mv square. Okay. Suppose this is equation number 1. For maximum acceleration or maximum energy attained by the positive ion, the velocity should be maximum. So this expression becomes E is equal to half m v max square. Equation number 2. But we know the expression centripetal force is balanced by force due to magnetic field. From this expression, the velocity v can be obtained, that is bqr upon m. Okay. Suppose this expression number 3. For maximum acceleration, for maximum energy, velocity should be maximum and radius also should be maximum. So this expression becomes v max is equal to bqr max upon m. Okay. So this is expression number 4. Put this value of phi in expression number 2. So expression number 2 becomes E max is equal to half m b square q square r max square upon m square. So when m cancels with this m, therefore the expression for maximum energy attained by the positive ion becomes E max is equal to b square q square r max square upon twice m. Okay, suppose this is expression number 5. The maximum radius of the circular orbit will be exactly equal to the radius of the d, that is r max should be equal to radius of the d. Therefore this expression becomes E max is equal to b square q square r square upon twice m. This is expression number 6. The expression number 6 shows the expression for the maximum energy attained by the positive ion in the cyclotron. Okay. At last, we will see limitations of the cyclotron. Number 1. In a cyclotron, energy of the positive ion is limited due to variation of mass with velocity given by theory of relativity. So according to theory of relativity, mass of moving particle is given by m is equal to m0 upon under root of 1 minus v square by c square. So by using this expression, the frequency of revolution of the ion becomes f is equal to dq upon 2 pi, instead of m it becomes m0 into 1 minus v square by c square. Okay. When velocity of the ion increases, the mass of the ion also increases, and due to this the ion lags behind the alternating potential of the radio frequency oscillator. Okay. So due to this, resonance condition breaks down, and instead of acceleration, deceleration takes place. This is a serious limitation of the cyclotron. Now, the second limitation of the cyclotron is maintaining uniform magnetic field in case of cyclotron is very tough task. So these are some limitations of the cyclotron. Friends, in this video, we have seen what are the particle accelerators, why the particle accelerators are used in the field of nuclear and particle physics. And we have also seen in detail the principle, construction, working, theory and limitations of the cyclotron. I hope you have understood. Thanks for watching. Please like and share my video, and please subscribe my YouTube channel. Thank you very much.